It has been 1.5 years since the first time I used the ArcticX Breeze USB fan for my test bench to cool my NVMe drive. It has been working amazingly over years, and in a video I made, it could lower 40 degrees C and prevents the drive from getting throttled. However, there are two problems with the fan. One, it could only work with open air test bench, so it can't be universally used for every PC. 2. Although the fan is quiet for normal usage, it is still very noisy to do voiceover like this, and I have to unplug the fan every time I record my voice. By doing so, my drive gets hot as I always edit my video on my NVMe drive. So today I will try replacing it with this baby 40mm fan from Noctua. The fan I chose is the tiny NF-A4x20 PWM version. You can also go with the 10mm fan if space is constrained, but the thicker, the better. Also, make sure to pick up the 12V instead of the 5V. In order to mount the fan to the M.2 heatsink, I suggest getting boxes of M.2 standoffs, M.2 screws, and M.2 or M.2.5 washers. Because the M.2 screw head is too small, the screw will fall through the fan mounting hole. We need an M.2 or M.2.5 washer to keep the screw in place. Then the fan will be mounted onto the nylon M.2 standoff, which will be then screwed onto the NVMe heatsink. Depending on the case clearance, you may need to choose the length of screws and standoffs accordingly. That's why I suggested buying all of them so that you don't have trouble when installing. Because the M.2 heatsink is lower for the Strix Intel board, I could use longer standoff and screw to mount the fan. But the heatsink for the Strix AMD board is much taller, so I had to use the shortest standoff. I mounted an extra female standoff to make it balance. The weather was 12 degrees C in San Jose, and here are the temperatures of the drives. The Western Digital Black NVMe was installed underneath the heatsink and was at 68 degrees. The Samsung 970 EVO was installed behind the motherboard. The temperature was 64 degrees for the memory chip and 83 degrees for the controller. The fan was unplugged, so these high temperatures were caused by the lack of airflow. I hot plugged the fan and set it at 3800 RPM via AI Suit 3. For some reasons, the fan keeps spinning at maximum speed when it boots to Windows, even though I set the fan curve in BIOS. Could be a conflict with AI Suit, which I have used for updating BIOS. And here's the result. Not only I could lower the temperature of the top drive from 68 degrees to 43 degrees Celsius, the temperature of the Samsung drive installed behind the motherboard was also improved. Memory chip temperature was dropped by 10 degrees from 64 to 54, and the controller was 13 degrees from 83 to 70. This means by cooling down the top drive, we could also lower the temperature of the bottom drive. Because the microphone of the iPhone doesn't record the sound very good, I had to boost the audio of the recorded footages by 25.1 decibel to compare. First, I will put the PC to sleep mode so that we can hear the sound that the USB fan made. Now let's listen to the noise when the entire machine is running without the USB fan. So, I think that USB fan alone is noisier than the fans on the AIO and the 40mm fan combined. Next, I want to see if I can benefit in the K39 build. The temperature for the M.2 SATA SU 800 drive is pretty good at 44 degrees, but for the Samsung PM961 NVMe drive installed behind the motherboard, memory temperature is okay at 61 degrees, but the controller temperature gets annoyingly high at 94 degrees. I tried playing some CSGO game and the game just crashed as it peaked higher than 100 degrees. So, I want to see if lowering the temperature of the top drive can also cool down the bottom drive like we just observed with the Intel board. Despite setting the fan to the maximum RPM, only the top drive benefited from the cooling solution as the temperature dropped from 44 to 32 degrees Celsius. However, the Samsung NVMe drive remained hot. In my opinion, the Strix X470i has a very thick heatsink for the top drive, so the airflow created by the fan could not reach the PCB. For this board, if I want to improve the back NVMe drive, I need to provide it with an actual heatsink. In conclusion, if your M.2 drives get too hot in your ITX case due to the lack of airflow, this tiny fan from Noctua is a great option, especially if you are using Intel boards. That's the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.